Hello everyone, and welcome back to our inventory system series in Godot 4. Before we jump into the fun parts of creating our system, we first need to establish our base for our project. Okay, so go ahead and open up your Godot editor, and let's create a new project. You can also create this inventory system in a pre-existing project if you'd like. I'm just not sure how it will integrate with your game, but because we're not depending on any pre-created functions from another project, it should work. I'm going to call my project Inventory System and make sure to save it in a folder where you can easily find it. I once accidentally saved my project in a random temp folder, and for the life of me, I could never find it again. You can leave it in compatibility mode and click Create and Edit. While that is setting up, let's head over to my GitHub repository that I created for this project. You can find the link for it below and download this folder called Download This. It might seem sketchy, but I promise you that it only contains our assets and our demo map which I created for this project. All the credits for the assets which I found on itch.io can be found on the repository if you'd like to check out the creators, and the final source code can also be found here. As a general tip, I'd like to encourage you to refrain from viewing this code up until you've reached the end of this tutorial series. Copying and pasting without doing the actual work doesn't make you a good developer. After the folder has finished downloading, unzip it and also unzip the assets folder within the zipped folder. Then, drag both the assets folder and the tilemap scene into your project. Now back in your project, let's create two new folders, one to hold our scenes and one to hold our scripts. Now let's create a new main scene which we will have our player and items spawn on. Save this scene as main in your scenes folder. Don't forget to also rename the root node to be main. To the root node of your main scene, attach a new script called main and save the script in your scripts folder. We'll come back to this script at the end, but we'll just create it for creation's sake now. If you don't have a map already, then drag the tilemap scene that came with the downloads folder into your main scene tree. Right-click onto the node and select Make Local. This will turn the scene back into a local node, and I assume you know what a scene and a node is if you're following an inventory system creation tutorial. You can now go ahead and delete the scene that we created. We don't need it anymore since we made our tilemap node local to our main scene. Okay, so we have our main scene, our map, and our project created. Now we'll quickly head into our project settings menu and add the inputs that we need for our game. We need to create two inputs. The first one will be to open up and close our inventory menu, and the second one will be to pick up items from the ground. So let's create a new input called UI underscore inventory and assign any key to it. I'm going to use the key I on my keyboard. Then let's create another input called UI underscore add and assign the E key to it. We also need to change the texture filtering of our sprites to make sure that our sprites are not blurry or foggy. If you look at your map, everything looks a bit blurry, and that's because it's not filtering to the nearest pixel. So back in your project settings menu, underneath rendering texturing, let's change our texture filtering from linear to nearest. Now our pixels should be sharp and crystal clear. The last thing that we need to do for this part is to create our player that can run around the map with animations and such. So let's create a new scene with a character body 2D node as its root node. This node will allow our body to execute physics so that it can move around the map. Rename this node to player and save this scene into your scenes folder. We're also going to attach a script to it and save that script in our scripts folder. You will see that it already comes with code built in, but we're going to go ahead and delete this since I want to add my own code with my own unique animations. To our scene, let's add an animated sprite 2D node as well as a collision shape 2D node. We'll assign our circle shape 2D node with a simple circle shape 2D shape. We'll also add a camera 2D node to our scene so that we can follow our player around. We'll change the zoom value of our camera to 3 because we want to be pretty close to our player. Now, let's add a few animations to our player that we will play when we move them around. Click on your animated sprite 2D node and add a new sprites frames resource. To this resource, we will add 5 new animations called idle, walk up, walk down, walk left, and walk right. We'll add some frames from a sprite sheet to our idle animation. And I want you to navigate to assets/assets, sorry, I made a mistake, and select the person.png sprite. Now we can count 8 frames horizontally and 8 frames vertically, so we're going to crop it out by saying 8:8 on the horizontal and vertical axis. I assume that you probably already know how to do this, I just love explaining. For our idle animation, we'll select the very first and only the very first frame. For our walk down animation, we'll select frame 0 to 5. Walk left will be the last one, 0 to 5. Walk right will be the second last row, 0 to 5. And then walk up will be the third last one, 0 to 5. I'm going to leave my frames per second for all of them at 5 and the looping value to on, because it won't matter since this isn't my real game and this isn't my real character. But with our animations created, let's open our player script and add our code for movement. First, we're going to define a new variable called speed, which will be our movement speed. Later on, we can increase or decrease the speed value if our player consumes an item with an effect. We'll get more into that later. Then, let's create a new function called getInput. In this function, we will use the input.getVector method to get a directional vector based on the player's input, which is our input using the arrow keys or WASD. We'll then multiply this vector by the speed variable to determine the player's velocity. This will determine whether or not our player moves in a positive or negative value on a vector scale. I'm not going to go into this too much, since I assume you already know how this works, but I am making another tutorial series where we will go into this a little bit more in depth. Now, in our physicsProcess function, we will call this newly created function. The physicsProcess function is called every physicsFrame, so it's typically where we handle physics-related updates. We also need to call the move and slide method to actually execute the physics on our body. This will then move our player in the determined velocity based on our input. Remember to save, and in our main scene, we will now create an instance of our player scene. Drag your player a little bit more inwards on the map, and now if you run your scene, your player should move if you press an input. All that's left to do now for the rest of this video is to add animations to our movement. We'll create a new function that will check the direction of the velocity vector and play the corresponding animation. We'll also create a node reference to our animated sprite using the onReady keyword to delay our node's initialization until it is fully ready and added to the scene. This will allow us to not only initialize our nodes when it's available, but it also makes our code look cleaner, since we don't have to call the node each time we want to access it. We can just call the variable instead. Also call this function in your physicsProcess function. Now if you run your scene, your player should move around the map and play its corresponding animations. I got an error called there is no animation with the name walk down, because in my animated sprite, I accidentally put a dash instead of an underscore in my walk down. So make sure that your animations are named exactly as it is listed on the screen. Now if you run your scene, your player should move around the map and play its corresponding animations. And that is it for this video. In the next part, we will start with our step one of our inventory system, where we will create our first component, which is our inventory manager. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one.